What's up guys, Sal here. So Huawei recently unveiled this latest flagship, the Mate 30 Pro, which is supposed to compete against the likes of the Galaxy Note 10 Plus and iPhone 11 Pro Max. But it has one huge problem that basically puts it out of the competition for now, as it doesn't have Google services. Unless Trump gives a green signal to Google to work with Huawei, they can't use any Google apps or even the Play Store. But it looks like that isn't stopping Huawei from releasing new breakthrough devices. Huawei is all set to launch an all-screen smartphone with the camera hidden underneath the display. Yes, the first commercial smartphone with the in-display camera is finally coming. By the way, a few months ago, Xiaomi and Oppo showcased a phone with an in-display camera, but the thing is, those were concept phones, which means you can't buy them. But it isn't the case with Huawei. They are actually gonna sell this to public. Deb Su, VP of Advanced Technologies, Principal Analyst and Technology Futurist at Athlon Research, tweeted that Huawei will announce the new device on 17th of October in France. The in-display camera tech is still in its infancy as seen on Xiaomi and Oppo devices, so if Huawei indeed goes on to showcase this new smartphone on October 17th, then I guess they could push back the release to next year considering the scenario they are currently in, and it only makes sense, because just like the Mate 30 Pro, no one would be willing to spend an absurd amount of money on a phone without Google apps. In any case, I'll keep you updated on what happens on October 17th, so you can consider subscribing for that. So here comes some good news to Huawei. Some US companies will soon grant licenses to work with Huawei. The New York Times reports that Trump has made a decision during last week's meeting to approve licenses to some US companies, provided there is no national security risk. Which is certainly a good news to Huawei and some American companies working with Huawei because they were losing a lot of revenue. Now, we don't know which product categories falls under the safe category, whether or not these licenses will be extended to software and hence Android will remain to be seen. But it's certainly good news for Huawei and its customers. In reality though, it's all political. You see, negotiators from the United States and China are meeting up in Washington this week for their 13th round of trade talks, and it's apparent at this point that the US is using Huawei as a bargaining chip. So allowing licenses to some of the US companies could help smooth the path to a trade deal. In any case, I hope the future trade talks go well and they finally let Huawei use the Google apps and services. I'll keep you updated about this, so please consider subscribing for that. And as always, I'll see y'all tomorrow. Peace out.